Today, I'm going to show you how to build an outbound AI voice agent that you can sell to businesses on repeat. A lot of YouTubers like to show videos like, ooh, check out my outbound AI voice agent that cold calls people. But the people building and using cold calling agents are going to get slapped by regulators. Because cold calling with AI voice agents is not only unethical, it's illegal, at least in the US. What I'm showing you today is 100% legal and is crazy valuable to businesses that will pay a lot of money for them. This is also a system that you can just build once and then just tweak a little, and then you can resell it to clients, which helps you save time and avoid burnout. So if you're into making money by selling AI and automation solutions, hit the like button and subscribe. You're also gonna wanna stick around to the end of this video because I'm making a very exciting announcement. Now let's dive in. Okay, so I'm going to show you how this AI voice agent works for my use case, and then I'm going to talk you through exactly how you can use it for your own use case. So it's triggered by this webhook. So the thing that differentiates this AI outbound voice agent from all the illegal ones that you see on YouTube is that the people who are being called actually want to be called by this business. And so this webhook is capturing leads that come from a platform called Angi. So if you are a home service business owner or you've ever worked with a home service business, Angi is a third-party platform that sells leads to contractors, and basically whatever person, like it goes out to you and all of your competitors, and whichever of you can contact that person first is probably going to get that job. And so it's super important to be able to call that lead immediately, and that's the whole reason why I built this outbound voice agent to begin with. So when the lead fills out a form on Angi, it's going to hit that webhook in n8n. And then that's going to get passed to this HTTP request. And this URL is pulled straight from the Vappy API documentation. So it's going to be a post request. So it's sending information from the webhook to Vappy, where my AI voice agent lives, and is going to initiate that phone call. And so this is the URL that we're sending it to. And then we're also sending the header parameter authorization with bearer and then our API key. And then we're going to send JSON body. And so let me expand this. But this is what it's going to look like. It's going to have the assistant ID hard-coded. It's going to have the phone number ID hard-coded. And I'll show you where we can grab those in just a second. And then we need the actual phone number. And that's coming from the webhook. So on the left-hand side, we're just going to drag and drop phone in between these quotes. And at least in the US, it needs to be in an 11-digit format with the plus in front. So +1 559 555 1234. Okay, let me show you how to get the assistant ID and the phone number ID. It's super easy and you can just plug them right in. So if we come over to Vappy, this is our outbound agent, Amanda, but this is her assistant ID right here. So we'll just click this copy assistant ID button. And then to get the phone number ID, we can just come over here to the phone numbers tab. And then the phone number ID is right up here in the top corner, and we can just click that copy button as well. And then the last step is there needs to be a response to the webhook. And the reason why that's so important is if it doesn't receive a response to the webhook, so if the Angi platform doesn't know that the payload has been received, it might keep sending that payload. And that could result in multiple outbound calls, and we don't want that. So this step is critical. And so this is what the respond to webhook node looks like. It just has a response code of 200 with this message in this field. So it's really simple on the n8n side. But what this is going to do is it's going to trigger a phone call from Vappy. And I'm going to show you a full test call. But when I was testing it earlier, it was working within 5 seconds of being triggered. And so it literally makes the call damn near instantly. And so this is perfect for leads that need to be contacted right away. So high intent leads. And actually research shows that leads that are contacted within the first minute that they submit a request are 400% more likely to convert to a paying customer than if you wait 5 minutes. So this is insanely powerful for businesses that are receiving inbound leads, but they need to contact them via phone call immediately. Okay, so now I'm going to go over to Vappy and show you the actual voice agent setup and how the agent actually makes the calls. And before any of you haters come into the comments saying, oh, AI voice agents are gonna take over the world and put everybody out of jobs, girl, please. If an AI voice agent can do a job, it's not that important that a human needs to be doing it. And I said what I said. Outbound voice agents free up humans' time so that they can go do something that's more important that only a human can do, like think with a human brain. Something that some people in my comments don't be doing. Okay, so let's head over to Vappy so that you can see the setup over there. Okay, so I'm gonna be dead honest. I don't like doing work if I don't have to. And so what I did is I just cloned. If you come up here to Vappy in the upper right-hand corner, you can click duplicate. and I just duplicated my inbound voice agent that I use for my 9-to-5. And then I just made some tweaks to the system instructions. So if you haven't watched the video on how to build an inbound AI voice agent, I highly recommend doing that right here and then coming back to this video. But really, the only things that I had to change between my inbound voice agent instructions and this outbound voice agent was this. So the first message mode needs to change from the assistant speaking first to the assistant waits for user. And the reason for that being, when the outbound voice agent makes a call, they're waiting for the human to pick up the phone and say hello before they start speaking. And then changing the first message to say, hi, this is Amanda calling from XYZ Business. How are you? And then really the only thing that I changed in the conversation flow was this first line. So I'm calling about the request that you submitted for your insulation project. Would you like to book a free inspection for an estimate? So just identifying the purpose for why they're calling, that should be like the first line in any conversation flow for an outbound agent. And then everything else is going to be the exact same. So all the tools that she's got access to using, such as checking Google Calendar, creating events on Google Calendar, and sending structured data to n8n via webhook, all of that is exactly the same. And if you want access to the system instructions, all the blueprints for this build, and all of the assets that I have for all my previous builds, click the link down in the description and you can get access to the vault. So she's still gonna have access to all the knowledge base files, just like the inbound agent, and all the same tools as the inbound agent. And then at the end of the call, she's gonna take all the structured data, such as the caller name, email address, like all that good stuff, and gonna send it to the exact same webhook that inbound calls also send their data to. And so we're basically gonna be able to reuse the existing infrastructure from our inbound voice agent. And that's why this setup is so easy. So I didn't have to reinvent the wheel. I didn't have to do a bunch of other builds. I just reused the same, almost the same exact AI voice agent with just a couple tweaks and the same backend infrastructure in n8n. That logs and organizes these calls and then creates automations and actions that run off the back of them. And building workflows that you can extend and reuse in the future for multiple clients is one of the keys to avoiding burnout. Okay, let's go back over to n8n and I will show you the exact infrastructure that this data is going to hit and then what that process, that workflow looks like. Okay, so this is the existing infrastructure that I already had for my inbound voice agent with just one small tweak. And I bet you could guess what it is. It's the if node. So if it's outbound, then it has this path because the data is going to the exact same place. It's going to be in the exact same format, but it's just going to be mapped slightly differently. And so this is what it looked like before. So this infrastructure is already existing. And I have some outbound data in this webhook pinned. So I'm going to show you exactly how we map it here. But I'm going to add this if node. And if it's outbound, it's going to follow this pathway. So the exact same as the inbound pathway, where it's creating a record in Airtable, it's executing a sub workflow, which I'm going to show you in just a second. And then it's going to respond to the webhook again. So it doesn't go haywire and it's not firing a bunch of times to this webhook because Vappy doesn't know that it's been received. So let me just go ahead and push through some of this data so you can see what it looks like. Okay, so now we have it all the way through the HTTP request. So this is, again, simulating inbound phone calls and outbound phone calls all coming into the same webhook. Because basically, anytime a call ends from Vappy, it doesn't matter what voice agent it is, it's going to send all of that call data to this webhook. So this is how I have the if node formatted. So if outbound phone call is equal to outbound phone call, this JSON type, then it evaluates as true and passes it to the pathway for outbound mapping. And so where I get that is just right here from this type. So if I execute that step, it evaluates as true. And now we can come in here to Airtable, and this is already connected to our database, and we just need to map everything across. And again, if you haven't seen the how to build an AI voice agent video, highly recommend checking that out and then coming back here. And let's move on to the juicy stuff. So once the call has been made, the outbound call, and then the end of call report, which has all the structured data like the caller's name, their phone number, when their appointment was scheduled for, that's going to come through this workflow. And then it's going to execute this sub workflow, which comes here. And again, this is all just reusing the exact same infrastructure for the inbound voice agent. And if you want to know how to build this full call center replacement, click this video, watch it. It's fantastic. And it will walk you through step by step of how to build this entire infrastructure out yourself. But now this agent is going to send like a confirmation SMS and a confirmation email to the person that just booked an appointment. And if there's anything else that needs to be escalated or notified to the team, then it's going to send a text or an email here. But this has so many use cases beyond just Angi leads, right? Although for home service businesses, that is a serious selling point. But this is also valuable for businesses that get a lot of like web traffic and web forms submitted. So when a web form is submitted, then the business can have an outbound agent set up to call that person back, book an appointment, answer questions, etc. Or for appointment confirmation calls. So that's great for contractors, med spas, doctor's office, dentists. You could even set this up after you've performed work for a customer or a client and say, hey, how did we do? We just want to check in and make sure you're happy with the work we performed. And then if they say yes, hey, great, would you be willing to write us a review or give us a video testimonial? This can even assist salespeople. Hey, did you get the estimate we sent? Just want to check and see if you have any questions. But what I'm trying to say is this is not just like a one-off tool, like a custom thing that you can only build for one business and that's it. Once you build this infrastructure, it is reusable across clients, across verticals, and even within your own business. Like I said, I built the inbound voice agent for my 9-to-5 and then I built an outbound agent and that took 30 to 60 minutes. Okay, now I want to test my voice agent. So I'm going to come over here to phone numbers. So I'm going to enter the outbound phone number, which is just my cell phone, and I'm going to enter the assistant, which is Amanda, and we will wait for her to give us a call. Hello?
Hi, this is Amanda calling from XYZ Business. How are you?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm glad to hear that. I'm doing well. Thank you for asking. I'm calling about the request you submitted for your insulation project. Would you like to book a free inspection for an estimate?
Oh, yeah, that would be great. Thank you.
Wonderful. May I have your first and last name, please?
Yeah, it's Jane Smith.
Thank you, Jane. Could you please provide your phone number?
Yeah, it's 559-555-1234.
Thank you for that. May I also have your email address?
Yeah, it's jane@example.com.
Thank you, Jane. Could you provide your street address, including city and zip code?
Yeah, it's 123 Example Road, Fresno, 93728.
Thank you for the information. Any special access instructions, such as gate codes?
Yeah, the gate code is 666.
Thank you, Jane. One moment while I check our calendar for available slots for your free attic inspection. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much.
For your free attic inspection, we have August 20th at 10 a.m. or August 20th at 3 p.m. available. Which works best for you?
Could we actually do August 27th at any time?
Unfortunately, we don't have availability on August 27th. The next available slots are on August 20th at 10 a.m. or 3 p.m. Would either of those work for you?
Yeah, we could do 3 p.m.
Great. Just to confirm, I'll book your appointment for August 20th at 3 p.m. Please allow a one-hour arrival window. Are you flexible on time, like if we were to arrive earlier or later than scheduled?
Yeah, I'm flexible both before and after.
Just a sec.
Thank you.
Great. You're booked. You're welcome. Great news. You're booked for August 20th at 3 p.m. Please allow a one-hour arrival window.
Great. Thank you.
You're welcome, Jane. If you have any more questions or need assistance in the future, feel free to reach out. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you. Bye. So not bad. Amanda was able to make the call, book the appointment. And now, like I said, that's going to end up in my Airtable database. It's going to send notification to the person that booked the appointment, which was me in this case. But when you compare that it would take our office of humans 4 hours to call those leads, and many of them were lost to competitors because we were failing to call them in a timely manner, and now they can get phone calls literally within 5 seconds after submitting their request, there's no comparison. So this is extremely valuable. I'm excited to use it at my 9-to-5, and I'm excited to see all the use cases that you can put this use for, of course, legally and ethically. And now for the exciting news. I'm launching a free school community to help you learn how to build AI and automation solutions that are actually valuable and that businesses will actually pay for. And I'm offering free one-on-one calls for the first 20 people who join. So if you want to get notified when the community launches, click the link down in the description. And if you watch this video and you can see just how valuable these outbound AI voice agents are for businesses, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe because I drop 2 videos each week that teach you how to make money by creating real value without the BS and burnout. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.